Good morning everyone. My name is Dr. Nitin Tyagi. I am Associate Professor in Department of Practice of Medicine. My today's topic is celiac disease. Definition: celiac disease, also known as gluten enteropathy, celiac sprue or non-tropical sprue. Definition: chronic inflammation of bowel due to congenital hypersensitivity to gluten. The disorder is referred to as celiac disease in children and celiac sprue in adults. Epidemiology: it is more common in women. There is family history, 10% of first degree relatives are affected. Etiology: it is common with other autoimmune diseases. Gluten, a protein in cereal grains, is toxic factor. HLA-B8 chromosome 6 found in 80-90% of patient compared with 20% in general population. It is also associated with HLA-DW3. Pathology: there is villus atrophy and crypt hyperplasia. There is increase in the number of plasma cells and lymphocytes in lamina propria. Similar pathology seen in small bowel overgrowth, Crohn's disease or lymphomas. Pathogenesis: a genetic predisposition, HLA-DR3 or HLA-B8, leads to formation of antibodies that attack the epithelial anchoring fibrils, reticulin, when the patient is exposed to gluten. Pathogenesis: the resulting chronic inflammation produces necrosis and separation of intestinal and dermal epithelial cells. The precise cause of this inflammation bowel disease is still unclear. The fundamental disorder in celiac disease is a sensitivity to gluten. Gluten is the alcohol-soluble, water-insoluble protein component known as gliadin of wheat and closely related grains like oat, barley and rye. The hallmark of this disease is a T-cell mediated chronic inflammatory reaction with an autoimmune component that is most likely developed as a consequence of a loss of tolerance to gluten. These are the changes which are occurring in the celiac disease. Interplay between the genetic predisposition factors, the host immune response and environmental factors in central to disease pathogenesis. The small intestinal mucosa, when exposed to gluten, accumulates intraepithelial CD8 plus T cells and large number of lamina propria CD4 plus T cells, which are sensitized to gliadin. There is damage to the small bowel, damage to the normal villi causes enterocytes to destroy themselves with resulting atrophy of the villi. The skin, there is separation of the epidermis occurs, producing cutaneous vesicles, dermatitis, herpetiformis. Morphology: there is lymphoplasmacytic inflammatory infiltrate in the mucosa of the small bowel and destruction of the villi leads to atrophy of villi or the flat mucosa and compensatory deepening or hyperplasia of the crypts of the small bowel. Histological results: there is hyperplastic crypts with loss of villi. These are the crypts which are deepened in celiac disease. Clinical presentation: there is malabsorption syndrome due to inadequate fat absorption. Symptoms are fatty stool steatorrhea with deficiency of essential fats, primarily leads to deficiency of fat-soluble vitamins, especially vitamin D. Osteomalacia: deficient absorption of vitamin D1 prevents ossification of cancellous osteoids in bone tissue. This results in cancellous bone with broad osteoid borders. There is breakdown of bone by osteoclast, remains normal, resulting in bone softening and deformation. These are the pathological changes which are occurring in the bone due to deficiency of vitamin D1 in celiac disease. Signs and symptoms: may present anytime from infancy when cereals are introduced to elderly, but peak presentation in infancy and old age. Especially classically, there is diarrhea, weight loss, anemia, symptoms of vitamin or mineral deficiency. The disease is most severe in proximal bowel, therefore iron, calcium and folic acid deficiency can also occur. Investigation: the small bowel biopsy, usually duodenum. The stool shows steatorrhea. The serum shows low levels of ferritin, iron saturation, D-xylose, calcium ions, iron ions and albumin and cholesterol. The celiac disease or gluten sensitivity enteropathy, the normal mucosa biopsy compared to the abnormal biopsy, a peroral jejunal biopsy specimen of diseased mucosa shows diffuse severe atrophy and blunting of villi with a chronic inflammatory infiltrate of the lamina propria. Diagnosis: evidence of malabsorption or localized or general, there is statoria, low levels of ferritin, iron saturation, dialyse, statoria, calcium ions, iron, then albumin, cholesterol, keratons, and B12 absorption. The abnormal small bowel mucosal biopsy, full clinical and histological recovery in response to gluten-free diet, the positive serum endomysial antibody 90%, sensitive and specific. Treatment: gluten, restriction in diet, barley, rye, oats, wheat, then rice and corn flour diet and acceptable. Complication associated with increased risk of colon carcinoma or lymphoma. Tropical sprue. The tropical sprue is defined as chronic progressive malabsorption in a patient or on from the tropics associated with abnormalities of small intestinal structures and functions. Tropical sprue. In a biopsy specimen from the small intestine of a patient with tropical sprue, the villi are broadened and shortened and the crypts are deepened. These changes yield the villus to crypt ratio of 1:1. Etiology mainly occurs in West Indies and Asia, including South India, Malaysia, Indonesia. The epidemiological pattern suggests that there is involvement of agents or agents. The small intestinal overgrowth with E. coli, Enterobacter and Klebsiella are frequent. Then pathology, the changes closely resembles those with celiac disease. There is partial villus atrophy is more common than subtotal villus atrophy. Clinical features, diarrhea, onset of severe diarrhea may be sudden and associated with fever. There is abdominal distension, anorexia, fatigue, weight loss. There may be edema, glossitis, stomatitis in chronic conditions, megaloblastic anemia from folic acid malabsorption and other deficiencies are common. Thank you.